Prince Harry is headed to the next stop on his 10-day royal tour of Africa, where tomorrow he is set to visit young women at a college and meet Malawi's President Peter Mutharika. Harry was seen accompanied by Angola's Minister of State for Social Action Caroline Isakara at Luanda Airport before his departure this evening. It appeared that the Duke of Sussex, 35, changed into something more comfortable for the flight, swapping his grey suit for a pair of navy trousers and a polo shirt. Now 6 days into the trip, the prince will continue to Malawi, the fourth stop on the tour and his third solo, while wife Meghan and four-month-old son Archie stay in South Africa. Today the Duke met with the president of Angola and learned about pioneering work on the transmission of HIV/AIDS from mothers to their babies, which is championed by the country's first lady Ana Dias Lourenço. Uniformed military saluted the Duke of Sussex as he first arrived for an audience with leader João Lourenço at the presidential palace in Luanda, Angola, on sixth day of his royal tour of Africa. Harry later visited a hospital to see the HIV project spearheaded by First Lady Lourenço, who he met yesterday evening during a reception at the British ambassador's residence. Posting on Instagram account Sussex Royal, the prince said the trip to Angola had been very important to him and he thanked the president for incredibly warm welcome. He wrote, "The trip has been very important to the Duke, allowing him to see the impact his mother has had, and also highlight issues that are so important to him, especially continuing her work to rid the world of landmines." The prince is expected to arrive in Lilongwe, Malawi, tomorrow morning and during his first day there will visit Nwakuo College of Education. He will interact with young women who are supported to attend and complete secondary school with the help of UK aid bursaries through the Campaign for Female Education. After this stop he will meet President Peter Mutharika and in the evening attend a reception hosted by the British High Commissioner. On Monday, among the Duke's engagements will be a visit to Lung National Park to pay tribute to Guardsman Matthew Talbot of the Coldstream Guards, who lost his life in May 2019 while on an anti-poaching patrol. After his visit to Malawi, the prince will join back up with Meghan in South Africa as they conclude their tour with high-profile meetings with Nelson Mandela's widow Grace Michelle and the country's president Cyril Ramaphosa. Prince Harry started the emotional pilgrimage to Angola yesterday, where his late mother launched an anti-landmine campaign, her last major crusade before her untimely death. Tragically, the princess never saw her work to secure a global ban on the weapons come to fruition. But yesterday her adored son retraced her footsteps, donning the same protective body armor and visor she did 22 years earlier to detonate a device in a partially cleared field in Diriko, in the southeast of the country. Harry walked into an area that was once an artillery base for anti-government forces who had mined the position in 2000, during the decades-long civil war that tore the country apart. It is reported that the prince met with President Lourenço to discuss continuing the campaign to remove landmines from the country. Like all those visiting the site, which is being cleared by the Halo Trust, the same landmine clearance charity that worked with Diana, Harry had been given a safety briefing and told not stray of the cleared lanes, touch anything or run. Speaking afterwards, the prince said, "Landmines are an unhealed scar of war. By clearing the landmines we can help this community find peace, and with peace comes opportunity." He and his wife, the Duchess of Sussex, also posted a message on their official Instagram page in which they honored his mother's work, which helped change the course of history. They added, "The Duke is humbled to be visiting a place and a community that was so special to his mother, and to recognize her tireless mission as an advocate for all those she felt needed her voice the most, even if the issue was not universally popular." The Duke and Duchess of Sussex's royal tour schedule. Day 1, 23 September. The tour began in a township in Cape Town, South Africa, where Prince Harry and Meghan joined children at a workshop that teaches children about their rights and provides self-defense classes. The couple also toured District 6 Museum to learn about the work done to reunite people affected by the apartheid. Day 2. The Duke and Duchess of Sussex traveled to Mungabazi Beach nearby to learn about Waves for Change's therapy program for those who have been affected by violence. Prince Harry then joined the City of Cape Town Marine Unit to learn about the work done to combat illegal poaching. In the afternoon, Meghan and Harry visited the oldest mosque in the country and finally attend a reception at the British High Commissioner's residence. Day 3. The Sussexes, accompanied by baby Archie, met the anti-apartheid Archbishop Desmond Tutu and Mrs. Tutu at their Legacy Foundation. From here, their Royal Highness's program split. The Duke will travel onwards to Botswana while the Duchess remains in South Africa. Meghan then remained in South Africa, visiting the Woodstock Exchange that encourages female entrepreneurs. Day 4. The Duke made a working visit to Botswana, first traveling to Chobe Forest Tree Reserve to join school children to plant trees and raise awareness of the fragility of these vital ecosystems. Prince Harry then spent the evening of 26 September at a new Halo Trust demining camp. Meghan Markle took part in a Women in Public Service breakfast at the High Commission in Cape Town. Day 5. The Duke remotely detonated a mine in a field outside Dirico. He saw aspects of the legacy that his mother Princess Diana started in raising awareness for the threat of landmines. He later met members of the local community and victims of landmines. His Royal Highness will give remarks about the importance of continuing demining. Day 6. The Duke has attended an audience with Angolan President Lourenço at the Presidential Palace. He then visited the maternity hospital Lucretia Paim to see the work of a project spearheaded by First Lady Ana Dias Lourenço, Born Free to Shine, which focuses on preventing HIV/AIDS transmission from mothers to babies. Meghan, meanwhile, visited a memorial to a young South African woman whose rape and murder inspired thousands of people to protest the country's high rate of sexual violence. Day 7. The Duke is set to arrive in Lilongwe, Malawi in the morning. He will later visit Nwakyul College of Education and interact with a network of young women who are supported to attend and complete secondary school with the help of UK aid bursaries through the Campaign for Female Education. The Duke will then attend an audience with the President Peter Mutharika, and in the evening attend a reception hosted by the British High Commissioner. Day 8. Prince Harry will fly into Liu National Park to pay tribute to Guardsman Matthew Talbot of the Coldstream Guards, who lost his life in May 2019 while on an anti-poaching patrol. His Royal Highness will witness an anti-poaching demonstration exercise conducted jointly by local rangers and UK military deployed on Operation Cordid. To conclude, His Royal Highness will dedicate Liu National Park and the adjoining Mangochi Forests to the Queen's Commonwealth Canopy Project to protect parkland from deforestation and other similar activities. Day 9. On the last day of his solo leg of the tour, the Duke will visit the Malwa Heath Centre before heading back to South Africa. Her Royal Highness will attend a roundtable discussion with the Association of Commonwealth Universities in Johannesburg. The Duchess will meet academics and students to discuss the challenges faced by young women in accessing higher education. Day 10. Have joined back up the previous evening, the Duke and Duchess will visit a township near Johannesburg to meet with inspiring local youth. They will also meet with Grace Michelle, the widow of the late President Nelson Mandela. To close the tour, their Royal Highnesses will attend an audience with President Cyril Ramaphosa and his wife Dr. Chpo Motsepe. Their Royal Highnesses will depart for London that evening.